Hi, I'm Susan Arndt, and this is the video supplement for my review of Bookworm Adventures 2. Bookworm Adventures 2 is sort of what you'd get if you crossed Scrabble with Street Fighter. You guide Lex the Bookworm through three different storybook lands, doing battle with enemies by spelling words. The longer the word, the more damage you do. Fortunately, there's no timer, so you can take as long as you need to come up with something devastating. You don't have to be a spelling champ to do well, though. There are plenty of power-ups to help you out. Using gem tiles in your words adds extra effects. Red tiles do fire damage, purple are poison, amber lower your enemy's power, green refills your health, and so forth. You can also use potions to give your words a bit more wallop. To complete each level, you'll have to defeat a number of increasingly difficult enemies and finally a gigantic boss. Your opponents are a bit on the goofy side and reflect the game's tongue-in-cheek vibe, but they can still pack a heck of a punch. Their attacks can cause all sorts of trouble, like locking letters, making them unavailable, filling the grid with hard-to-use letters, or simply stunning Lex to make him lose a turn. Defeating a boss earns you an item that will help you in combat, and you'll meet new sidekicks as the story progresses. You can decide which helper and which power-ups you'd like to equip before each chapter, so you should have no trouble finding a combination that works for you. The 30 chapters of Bookworm Adventures 2 should keep you busy for a while, but there's still plenty to do once you've finished off that final boss. You can replay adventure mode to earn badges, they're like achievements, fight the bosses in fast-paced arena combat, or play through a variety of mini-games that will help you hone your word-assembling skills. And besides, where else are you going to get to fight a cow in space boots?